awesome to have this guy around all the time.
Oscar! Bud Light here!
Bud Light? Bud Light?
Oscar! Bud Light here!
Bud Light's all around.
Oscar! Bud Light here!
Yep, right here.
Oscar! Bud Light here! 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 Oscar! Bud Light here!
I was wrong. This is where you belong. Now go before I change my mind.
Let's go for life here! Let's go for life here!
Here's to the friends you can always count on. Bud Light, brewed to be America's favorite light lager.
This thing is not tight enough here. It's kind of hey, what's going on YouTube? This is Kevin McKell. We are back with another video. I hope you guys enjoyed your previous week, and I hope you guys plan on enjoying your weekend. If you are down in Florida and you are being told to evacuate, please evacuate. And let's keep prayers for all those that's down in the Caribbean. Well, the islands, I know that they, the island of Barbuda, has been like 90% of the buildings have been destroyed there or suffered damage. And it says it's a city that's only about maybe an island with only about 1,400 people, but most of them are now homeless due to, you know, what happened with Hurricane Irma. And I know that it was going through Puerto Rico, but they were saying it's not as bad. But the storm is on its way to Florida, and I know that South Carolina has just declared a state of emergency because this storm is coming. Please find somewhere to go that is safe. Book a hotel somewhere, find some family somewhere, and go up north. If you can't fly, drive. I know they said the gas might be short and stuff, but, you know, they'll get some gas. Keep going until you find some gas.
And if you can't do either one of those, go to one of those shelters that they have set up.
Yeah.
Because they got shelters set up for you.
If you have nowhere to go.
And but don't stay home.
No.
Don't stay home.
No, they say it's going to be worse than Hurricane Andrew, and that was, what, 25 years ago. And I remember that. I didn't live there, but I remember seeing it on the news. But you guys, y'all have to be careful. They tell me y'all to leave me. And
I'm not as old to remember Hurricane Andrew.
You sure? Because I remember them talking about this. That was a long time ago.
Don't.
That's when I really, like,
you tried me, bitch. I'm only 27.
Yeah, don't try. 5 years older than that. What? I mean, what? Good thing. That 86 could be the front. You know, because 81, we know 81 is front. Let me stop. Okay, if you're first time watching to the Scorpion Show, please click that subscribe button.
Let you stop.
I better stop. Also, to everyone that's watching, like this video and share this video. Click the share button, share it to Facebook, tag me in your Facebook, or tag the Scorpion Show on Facebook. Get your friends to watch the videos. Also, if you're on your phone, you can also share it to Twitter or Facebook, or, you know, tag us on Instagram and let us know you're watching the Scorpion Show. You guys know we've been going for a week, and it's just been a lot going on with me, you know, with my mom and stuff like that. For those asking about my mom, thank you so much. Please continue to keep her in your prayers. Right now, she is at a rehab facility where they're trying to help her get her physical therapy back together because of the surgery that she had. She had to get open heart surgery, so you know, she has all of these staples. They really open her eyes. She got all these staples in her stuff like that. And she's being a little bit difficult. She's trying to go back to being a difficult, and I'm just like,
trying to go back.
Yeah, I'm just like, because, you know, when she was a baby, she was like one of the nice people. And now, like, you're like, you think you're going home? You're not going home. She didn't know that she was going home. I don't know, but I got two ambulance drivers. We went to the rehab place.
And she couldn't take her home.
Yeah, she was home. So, but I'm just like,
she has to stay in
me 2 or 3 weeks. But all I'm like, all you gotta do is do what you gotta do, people come home. Like, all you gotta do is cooperate with people. Don't be mean to them. But we had to leave her early because she was just like cursing and this. I was like, listen, I've been here for 5 hours. I cannot stay here with all of this. So we was out. So, yeah, it's just a lot going on. It's a lot going on. So I didn't have to, like, I want to run to the camera and stuff like that. But y'all, just keep our family in your prayers. Prayers, please. But yeah, my mom, she's starting to start tripping. And it's a lot because, you know, she don't want the oxygen thing. And yes. It's like, you need
and she
to wear that. She's
supposed to have been wearing that
a long time ago.
Yes.
It's just
that stuff is nothing to play with.
No. No. Like, you can't be like, ah, it's so frustrating because she's like putting them on the end and shit. And with her hair being blonde, you can't see the
right
clear things. So you just like, why is that on your head? Put that back in your nose. Yeah, she's just being very, very difficult. I guess she might be there because, I don't know, y'all. It's just tough. It's tough to know. But yeah, so enough about my shenanigans going on. This past weekend, you were able to attend on Sunday, Made in America.
I was.
So how did that happen? Think about it. How did that happen? Because y'all know I wasn't going. I don't. This is my first time ever going.
It happened, well, Michelle had texted Kevin and I last Saturday saying that she was hoping that she was in Philly and she was hoping that she'd be able to see us. Saturday she was not able to see us because both he was going to go see his mom and I was going out to a family event. So Sunday came around and I went to church and then I went to my friend, he had a brunch at his house, so I was saying to myself, you know, I think I might want to go down to Made in America to see them because, you know, they hit me up, and, you know, I talked to the event that day, too. And it was like, you know, you don't want people to come to your city, and they hit you up, and they want to see you, and then you're like, you know, so I was like, yeah, I'm going to go try to make it happen. Well, anyway, long story short, I got all the way down there. I didn't have a ticket, so I was going to go purchase a ticket. The lady told me, it's $115.
What? I know it was that high.
No, it was higher than that. It was just $150 for that. But it was higher than that. I said, oh no. And this is like midway through the concert. I said, oh no. So then, you know, I'm out there like, how the hell am I going to get in here? Well, honey, I saw this guy coming out and he was ripping his thing off. I said, you leaving? He said, yeah. I said, oh, can I have your thing? And he said, here.
No, that's not how I know. Or look, we're not on my own. Don't tell me how you worked your magic in here.
Because you know I worked it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, you know,
I don't have the space and this beard and this mouth for nothing. Okay?
You know, I worked it.
But I was in there.
Okay?
That was my first time I made in America, and it was a lot of people. It was a lot of drunk people. You would have loved it. It was awesome. But I don't mean it in a bad way because I keep telling everybody, even though everybody was drunk, it was like a fun type of drunk. Like there was no disorderly people. There was no, I didn't see anybody.
Yeah, I hear about no person.
And the cops were just like, let you do you. As long as you ain't, they let you do. There was a lot of people passing out for being drunk.
Yeah, because it's a crazy thing.
No! On Sunday it wasn't that high. I mean, well, it was, but I mean,
yeah, I mean, well,
it was a lot of fun. Because on Saturday, right? But anyway, long story short,
I was thinking something else.
Don't make that up. No. So, I got there, and you know, I was by myself. Now, naturally, there's people going to be there that you know. But it's so big, you don't know who's there, you don't know whatever it is going to be.
Was the cell phones working right with all of those people being in there?
Yeah, mine was. So, I texted Yvette and, you know, she told me where she was, and so I found her, and, you know, we were talking, and then I looked up, and there I said, Amber, your niece. In the Rock Nation, they had, like, their own box, like their bleacher box. And so we were laughing at that, whatever the case may be. You know, me and Amber were talking from the whistling. I guess she had to have a pass to get to whatever the case may be. So by this time, you know, because I didn't prepare to stay. I didn't plan on staying down there. I just planned on going to the eye and then taking my ass home. So I hadn't seen Michelle because Michelle was backstage with Beyonce. We were texting and she was like, you know, she's backstage, whatever the case may be. So I'm like, I said to Yvette, I said, well, listen, Yvette, listen, my phone's about to die. I'm getting ready, hightailing it out of here. So she's like, no, you can't leave, bitch. You haven't even seen Jay-Z. And I was like, well, I haven't seen him. She said, well, I know you already seen him, but you haven't seen him at Made in America. So I said, well, you know, I was thinking of every excuse I could think of to leave. I was. I didn't even want to see Beyonce. I was just like, I want to go home. I want to be around this crowd. I don't. And I don't feel comfortable because I'm not with people that I don't know. You know what I mean? I'm not with, and this is a big crowd. So she was like, and I was like, well, you know, and I really, really have to go to the bathroom because I really, really have to pee. So she was like, well, this is what you're going to do because you're not going to leave. You're going to go to the bathroom and then you're going to come back here and you're going to be with me. So I said, okay. She said, so go to the bathroom and I'm going to be standing right here. And I went to the bathroom and I came back and she was there right there. She was there with her sister and I think a few of her nieces and her two daughters. Well, Jay-Z came on, and we had a good time where we were at. I don't know if you saw the videos or whatever the case may be. I was, we had a good time. But then all of a sudden, I'm looking at where Amber was at, you know, and I'm like, that guy looks so familiar. And I'm looking, I'm like, hey, he looks really familiar. Then I realized it was Michelle's boyfriend. Mm-hmm. So I'm like, oh. And then I'm thinking, like, the girl that's on him, I'm like, hugging him from behind. I'm like, that gotta be Michelle. I'm like, really? Yeah.
Don't you start no stuff for you.
I'm just saying. Go. Then I'm looking, I'm like, I don't know who that girl is standing next to them because it didn't,
Look like her.
It didn't look like her. But then I saw Julius. And I said, oh, that is her. Okay. Because he's not from nowhere. So I went over to the bleachers, you know, and we're right there fighting. I'm like, yeah. But they can't hear me because of the fact all the noise. And by this time, Jay-Z is asking the crowd to say happy birthday. So now I'm over it because my phone is dead. I have no phone. You know, Amber's yelling at me. Amber's like, look, there's Beyonce. I'm like, bitch, I know. Hello. I'm on the phone. Hello. I know. The fuck? What do you think I'm standing right here? So, you know, Michelle sees me and she's like, ah. So, this, that, and the third, whatever the case may be. So then finally, Michelle points. You know, tells me, I said, here's what kind of the case anything. Mind you, I didn't even know all this was going on because I was so affected by my phone until I saw this video and I saw the video. I was like, oh. But yeah, it was really fun. I had a good time. Now, but I will, me personally, I won't go again.
Now, I don't know yet because, you know, Made in America always falls in line with gay pride in Atlanta. I didn't go this year, but I'm like, I do want to go back to pride. But I don't know, it's something I gotta work out. Maybe I can finally do that Made in America on that Saturday and go to the park. If I go to, my favorite thing about parking in Atlanta is the park anyway. Like, I just love it. It's better than Made in America. It's like I haven't been Made in America, but it's just a whole bunch of people. They got concerts going on and it's fun. But that Sunday lineup for Made in America, I did not like the lineup for it. I think it's like, it should be a little bit more action packed and more names on it for it to be a big weekend of Philly because Jay-Z was like the only headline act that I knew personally that was on the Sunday thing. I know it normally don't be like that.
Well, let me tell you something. You feel that way. But them people was out there having a ball. Okay? Let me tell you, I was looking at them and I said, ooh. See, let me tell you something. You don't listen to those artists, and I know you don't. Because let me tell you something. Exactly. Them artists was out there and them people were out there having a ball. And I mean, they were singing, they were jamming. So, yeah, even though you don't know them, those are out there.
The Saturday show would have been for me.
Yeah,
everybody.
The Sunday, let me tell you something. There were some artists that I was just like, I don't know. I've heard the song before, but I don't know. And let me tell you something. Every time, because you know it's different stages, so whenever an artist pops up, the crowd just grabs the rest of that stage until the next artist, and then they gravitate to it. And I mean, it's just like, you'd be like, oh my God, what's people coming towards? I can't do it. Baby, I know it had to have felt good for the artists who were on the smaller stage, but the big stage is the one that, you know, they had to have been like, this is awesome that all these people are keep flocking to us and they know our, like, because I mean, these people, you gotta remember too, it's a lot of white people too out there. You know, this is a festival, so it ain't just for us, it's for everybody. So, I mean, no white people out there having a ball. So, I mean, I'd say kudos to Jay-Z and whoever, you know, kudos for bringing Made in America to Philly because it's a good thing. Yeah, I would like for it to stay here too. I really would like for it to stay here too because it's a good thing. It's a good thing for the city. It really is a good location, the Parkway. I mean, me personally, I think maybe it kind of should be in like one of the stadiums or something. But then again, I thought about it and I said no, because, you know, only the people on the floor. What about the people in the seats, you know? So
they got to sit through every I want to hear this shit.
Right. Yeah. So, yeah. So it's a good thing how they have the Parkway barricaded. You know, the whole Parkway is basically like gated off. So, I enjoyed myself from what I had. And like I said, it was fun. But it's interesting because the bleachers at Beyonce and everybody, they were so far back. I kept saying to myself, there's no way on earth Beyonce is going to be on those bleachers. And Lord, they weren't. I'm thinking like, they're so far away from the stage. But
the main stage, far away from the main stage?
Yes, they were far away. Like, let's just say this. I can't even describe how it would be. But let's just say this is the main stage. Your laptop is the main stage. And we were off to the side. But we were off to the side all the way over there. So it was kind of like, you know, and I'm thinking like, wow, like, but.
But everybody,
everybody had a good time.
I seen the people from when they Philadelphia, they were at the show.
Everybody was there.
Yeah, they said there was a room where Jay-Z picked everybody out where they thought it was the end of the show.
I left.
You left at that point?
Yeah, because I left because the crowd, you know, at a certain point, that crowd that starts to leave, like, all right, well, let's get out of here so we don't be caught up in this. I was in that crowd.
Yes.
I didn't know that Meek Mill came out until the next day, but I was looking at it on the news, and I said, oh, Meek Mill? I didn't even know that. So that was awesome that he brought him out, whatever the case may be, but yeah, I left. Well, I can't sit in this show.
Yeah, but I'm glad you
put it. Yeah, I had a good time. I enjoyed this. But I can't see me doing that again. Not all day, but that's an all day thing, Kevin.
Can't get me. And so yesterday, well, actually, yeah, during this week, right? That's a nice picture, actually.
It is,
but very nice. I want to see some other stuff.
I shouldn't think like that. I should not think like that.
I know.
I'm going to tell them.
No, you better not have it. First of all, how can that conversation start?
You don't know the conversation. You don't.
Shut
you.
But we know that. Y'all don't know.
Listen. Baby. You know, I can have a conversation.
Yeah, don't stop showing it to you. So,
Texas.
Earlier this week, Janet said tweet like every single day.
Who?
Janet Jackson.
Oh, she said Jada.
No, Janet Jackson. And they're tweeting every day this week. And it's like, you know, she would tweet like a little clip from one of her songs. You know, like every time she tweets something, you know, it has to go on with what's going on in the world right now. It's so weird that this music is out from 20-something years ago, and it's still relevant today. And then it will be like a little advertisement for the tour. Excuse me. Then last night, Janet posted a video saying that she was in Louisiana, and she was backstage, you know, rehearsing and stuff like that. And she was saying to the people of Houston, she was like, the show is not canceled, and they actually had something planned. For the people of Houston, like, she's going to be visiting shelters and stuff like that, which I think is a great thing. And I'm just excited because the tour actually starts tonight in Lafayette, Louisiana. I'm hoping that Janet does more than two fucking outfits. I want it to be like how she normally does it, like 5 or 6 costume changes, a big production and stuff like that. I don't want it to be like you, like she did here with the two outfits. And when she was married, you know, with like 2 outfits. Girl, give us the Janet that we got. Show some skin and all that.
But it was still a good show.
Yeah, it was.
With the 2 outfits. And I don't even remember. I just remember it was a good show. I don't make outfits.
Yeah, I want her. I just want her to.
I didn't like outfits. So yeah.
Right. Yeah, so yeah, I want her to go back to that. But. Excuse me. I'm thinking, what the fuck is that? Is that a brand or something? That is bad. And I really need a call.
What do you use that stress relief for?
Huh? What?
That stress relief for?
Who's stress? Actually, it's so big. John.
That's the name of the sleep.
No, Raquel! Oh, never mind. I didn't forget I had to call for a bit, but I just had to call. There it is, right there. The loop, but now
it's a big,
in that big ass bottle.
No, I thought maybe you poured it like. You've been known to experiment.
No, I have not been known to experiment with no shit like that. Then you go back to watch some videos you be looking at. She ain't nuts. You ain't doing nothing like that. I met you. And you know I don't even need that.
Oh,
I don't need lube.
You can rest like that?
Hey, I could.
But anyway, that's another show.
That's all I spoke about.
Whoa, no!
Don't do that.
No!
Don't do that.
You get wet like that?
What?
No.
No, I don't want to explain it, but I don't need it.
Listen, let me ask you a question real quick, and we're going to get off of this subject.
No, we won't get to the subject. Listen, I'm going to get started.
Like, I just want to find out.
Yeah.
You know how?
No, I just need to say
I'm excited.
You saying this?
I'm pretty sure. I'm gonna say it for myself. How do you know?
I don't.
You're lying.
Because I know about you and some of these out here. I don't want to throw nobody under. Especially if y'all just named me, wasn't me watching. Who called my phone?
Baby!
I think my voicemail might be full because it's like they keep showing my voicemail thing. So, yeah, Jen is on tour. Get y'all tickets. I'm going November 13th, but she comes in to Philly and I can't wait. Are you serious? You seen that one? I'm getting sidetracked. All
right, go ahead.
For, let me stop.
Please stop.
No, you stop again. He
stopped.
Speaking of Jay-Z's mother, I hope this comes up right because I left it right on the
paper. Glory card.
Yeah. Miss, I'm about to say, why is that titties looking like that's what we're
going to do? She be a mother.
Who?
She's like, she be a mother.
Who mother?
She like, she can be his mother?
No, she don't.
You are trying.
Jay-Z looks just like his mother.
Yeah.
Just like
his mother. That's his
mother. So, I'm on JasmineBrand.com. This has a new interview. Jay-Z's mother, Gloria Carter, opens up about coming out to her famous son. I just finally started telling Jay who I was. Besides your mother, this is the person that I am. This is the life that I live. She says that Jay-Z actually became emotional. So my son started actually tearing. Because he's like, that had to be horrible like mine. I was like, my life was never horrible. It was just different. So that made him want to do a song about it. She continues, I was never ashamed of me. In my family, it was something that was never discussed. As to why she wanted to reveal her sexuality, she says, I'm tired of all the mystery. I'm going to give it to him. I don't have to worry about anybody wondering if I'm in the life or not. And you know she knows what she said in the life. I'm going to tell them. So now that I told you, what do you have to talk about? So now maybe you can focus on the phenomenal things I do. So focus on that. Now it's time for me to be free. Jay-Z also discussed the song Smile that was inspired by his mom. We had a beautiful conversation that led to me making that song. And I didn't have permission to make that song. When she first heard the song, she was like, absolutely not. I was like, this is so important. So many people in the world are hiding. This will help them. That's all I'll say about that. That's how we spoke about that song. I was just so happy of the person she's becoming. Live your life, be who you are. One of the proudest songs. One of my proudest songs. I love that song.
And I think that when he said to her, I think that had to have been horrible. I think he was basically saying to her, I think that must have been horrible for you to have to live in the closet, you know, for so long and not say anything. Because, you know, Listen, I've seen so many people say when this story came out that they didn't even know what his mom looked like. Now, of course, because I followed the family life, I knew that his mom was around. His mom's always around. If you pay close attention, his mom goes on vacations with them. She's always there. But even a few years ago, when I first saw his mom, I said to myself, So this was no secret. Today.
Yeah, so he had to know.
You know, so he had to know. I guess it was just a confirmation. Yeah, confirmation. But I mean, hello, because if you really know, if you can really tell, you know, like,
come on.
I did not, you know.
But sometimes you can be, like, in that, or in a family where you don't even have to have, not that you don't want to have it.
Right.
Just the conversation that I've had about how you sleep.
Right.
It's possible to have that. It can just be unspoken.
But I feel like, what is the point of having a conversation like that, you know, if heterosexuals are not, you know, having that type of conversation? Why do they feel like,
Because sometimes some people can be ashamed or feel ashamed that, you know, maybe, you know, I already know with this person what they like to do sexually, but they haven't had that conversation with me. Maybe she's ashamed to have that conversation with me because she hasn't told me about it. And when she said that she felt free just letting it out and just telling them, you know, that was, you know, I've never been in that situation where I knew about a Darren or something like that. But if I had my suspicions and even she never said anything, I would be thinking, I would be thinking a whole lot of stuff. But, you know, I'm glad that she was able to have that conversation with him, and they both were inspired afterwards. He was inspired to do his own, and she just was like, I'm free, and she can talk about it, because we never hear from her. We don't hear nothing about her. The only thing I heard about her was the song.
Yeah, the only thing I really knew about her was Sean Carter was born
December the 4th, yeah. December the 4th, right?
Okay,
yeah. He and Sean was a quiet child.
Yeah.
They do this. I don't like that song.
Yeah.
But how many parents out there are like that? There's a lot of parents out there that's like that.
What? They're saying Sean Carter?
They had children, and then become a lesbian. But you know what's so, it's not good, but
I know,
you know the funny thing is, the funny thing is that Jay-Z is speaking from his mother's side, saying where she had to hide who she was. Mm-hmm. And normally you don't hear stuff about women hiding because women would be accepted from anything, but from a man? Try this.
And I dare you to tell me I'm lying.
It's your lie.
No, I didn't. It is a mess.
But it's different.
How
many men out there are forced to get married and have children and then be on a low? And now at these age, you coming back bringing like all these kind of diseases. It's just a mess. And let's not act like they don't have anything because they do. And this is why we need to talk about this. If we stop acting like this a strange thing, There wouldn't be no need to be on the DL and undercover. Like, let people live and let them be who they want to be and stop shaming those. But you know what? It's always our people that do.
But how great is it that we got JC, one of the biggest in the industry, making a song about his mom in this way so that it can help other people? You know what I mean? Because some artists today would not think to tread in that territory. But then, again, we're talking about Jay-Z, he's not any typical artist. He has earned his stripes. He has earned his lane. He is Jay-Z. I feel like Jay-Z can basically talk about any damn thing now. You know what I mean? Because he's the goat.
Yeah, now it's like, if Jay-Z say so, then it's okay.
Right.
For a lot of these people out there, they follow him.
Or not that he has a lot of influence. And not necessarily it's okay, but I think it's, if Jay-Z is talking about it, okay, we should be able to talk about it too. You know what I mean? And yeah, a lot of people feel like, oh, well, if Jay-Z's talking about it, it don't make or break me, you know. But, you know, there are some people that do think that way. Just like if Rihanna says something or does something, there are a lot of her fans that are influenced by it, and then they go and do it. I don't have a problem with that, as long as it's something positive. If Rihanna's going to do and say something that's going to be positive, then by all means, I want her fans to jump on that bandwagon because it's taking a positive step. And that's for any artist. If Jay-Z is making a song about people hiding who they are and their sexuality, and he feels as though you are a mother and you are able to come out, you know, with this truth, I want to be able to help other people in that same way, then go right ahead and do that. You know what I mean? Because this album was a very successful album, 444, and, well, however you want to call it, 444, yeah, 444, 444, too many damn fours. It was a very successful album, and it can help people in that way. You know, and it's also an album that it just has you thinking. It's one of those albums that you be like, I'm thinking through this whole song, like, I mean, this whole album. Like, it'll have your mind going. It's not like these normal or these guys out here, like the little Uzi Verts and all them.
Yeah, I would be born with 2017 music. But I do like that Cardi B song. That's probably like one of the only songs I like. It's just like, and y'all know I used to do music reviews and all of that stuff. And it's just like, these bitches ain't bringing it. They're not. Nobody is bringing it. Nobody. Not this year. Not even Taylor Swift. But y'all eat it up because she's Taylor Swift. But she's not giving no vocals. Then that's not going
to be. But you know what? But I have to ask you one more question. Didn't you say real quick? Didn't you say that, didn't you say, yeah, but that's not what I was going to ask
you. You was not.
Do I
want
to help you?
Say it on camera.
No. I mean,
but what did he have to do with it?
No, and I saw him, and I was thinking about him. Because I still have
seen. Yeah, but I think so.
Because no, it looks like you're right.
It looked just like her.
Because you thought it was this one.
Yeah,
and I thought I knew it.
That's right. I don't know. I forget. Nobody got this stuff.
It was him, right?
No, I told you I don't drink.
Listen, I don't know.
This is that voice. Open that door.
That's outside. Trust me. That's outside.
This is a fucking mess. Sorry, y'all. So, Beyonce, happy birthday. Beyonce turned 36 this week. I believe she turned 36. And everybody was going off and, you know, posting Beyonce pictures. But the best pictures that I've seen was like the montage of everyone doing Beyonce's iconic formation video with the head and her two ponytails aside from the show Obama to Beyonce's mother
to Jay-Z's grandma.
Yeah. It's about but it was a bunch of people and bunch of female. What you said? Shout out to everybody who did the photo shoot. Happy birthday to Beyonce. And shout out to all of y'all for Jay-Z getting to sing up again to us singing happy birthday to her. Kiki Wyatt. Now, Kiki Wyatt is one of the best vocalists of this time. And you can take it to the bank. If I'm with you enough.
Oh, me.
Yeah.
Yeah, she might go off.
So, Kiki did a video crying on Tuesday. Now, I wasn't here for this. I'm like, bitch, hooray, Irma's coming. And you, mama, and then the doctor people, they about to get kicked out.
And you in a car crying.
How about your man?
How about you?
On you.
Which I'm sure he's been going for the past however many years I've been
here. Yeah. I mean, but
you can't tell me there's nothing wrong with what I'm scared.
She's crazy.
Yeah.
But that bitch can sing. I can say that.
But most crazy people are down.
Yeah.
A lot of them
are
strong. That's crazy.
I know about some crazy people.
That's strong, crazy. Crazy strong.
There's strong crazy. There's dick crazy strong.
Wait a minute. I don't know.
Well, listen.
Yeah.
white heads, all kinds of crazy. She's still inspiring. Like, I love her personality. I loved her on Army Defense. Yeah, so, you know, I feel bad for her, you know, her son has leukemia, and they're going through that, and now she's pregnant, and so she's trying to treat one child, she got 8 other children, and then, you know, he's cheating on her, and all this and that, but then again, a lot of people are saying that this was for, maybe this was for publicity for their marriage boot camp show, so we don't really know if they're getting a divorce, but Michael was like, listen, it's a toxic environment. He don't want his children to be growing in a toxic environment. He didn't say exactly what the toxic environment was, but, you know, but haven't they been growing in this toxic environment? Yeah, if y'all got all of those children, he said, I love all her children, whether some of them are mine or not.
Oh, yeah. I know it.
No, she's been married before.
Oh,
Kiki might be in some kind of way, but you can see that in the relationship that she was the more dominant person in their relationship, just from watching the little R&B Divas. But he still was doing his thing, and he loved her, and she really believes her man fruitful and multiplying. That's what I can say. She got more children than Vince, and that's a shame. But you know what? I'm not going to do that. But, Kiki, I don't know what else to say, but y'all pray for y'all that y'all get it right. And I hope that you two don't get a divorce, because who knows how the children's going to take it. They all they know themselves being there, and you got all of these children, and then Kiki got to start all over, and it's going to be hard to try to get a man if you got 9 other children and a newborn.
Yeah.
Kiki,
can you imagine
that? Because that's me dead, and all the kids eat that. 12.
Now, what year is this?
Okay. I didn't know people still had that many kids in 2014.
No. She has a lot of kids.
A lot.
What is this, the 9th one?
The 9th one.
She has a lot of kids.
Yes.
I thought this was 1965 when she popped them kids. She's popping them.
And she's young. She's not even 40 yet.
Yes.
Tie those tubes.
Okay.
You don't need.
No. Let me tell you something. You are set. You will get old. Your kids are going to make sure they take care of you, baby.
Okay.
You don't worry about that. You got a whole village.
And she got a village over her house,
okay?
Yeah, so Kiki, no more.
Kiki, let me tell you something. Your kids are gonna love. You ain't gotta make no. I mean, she must love making kids. She got you.
But there's people that love being in love and love making children.
And there's some women who love being pregnant.
Yeah, but you know what? 9 is too 9 too many. It's 9 is 9 too many.
1 is 2, 1 too many.
Okay. To carry.
I don't know how you do it. I don't know how those people do all love people like that.
Do what? That's what you're supposed to do when you want children.
Well, you can't have them, so how do you keep letting them?
I can't have children.
Oh. I can't carry children. Well, then why do you keep letting them do what they're doing?
Who? You doing what? You're trying to try me? You're trying to try. I'm not trying.
You know why I can keep letting them do it?
Who, you?
You are nasty. I've seen that before.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did. I swear to God.
Wait,
I don't swear. I've seen.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, I've seen that.
But I'm thinking you're talking about.
Oh, no.
No.
But you never know. Because you know I think she was both of them.
Woo!
And you know I don't forget a face.
True.
You know I don't.
No, you don't. All of it is no man face one time.
Yeah.
So not, no,
I stopped him at his track and said, I know you from somewhere. It ain't from Deliverville.
Yes, you did.
Yes, I did him that. I said, it's not from Deliverville. And you're not from
Deliverville. He's a baby like Deliverville.
I don't care. I know that face from somewhere. He was like, I don't give a fuck where you live at. Because I didn't say I saw you.
You said you're from New Jersey.
Yeah. That's what he said. But I ain't seen you in Jersey.
Yeah.
I don't know.
That's why y'all gotta stop putting your face like that.
People,
your face.
People like me don't forget faces or tattoos.
No. Now I can forget a tattoo.
I don't.
But a face?
I'll see a tattoo like I saw it somewhere before. You hear me? Then I go start scrolling through my phone and say, because I got a section that says tattoos.
Yeah. But you know what? People be having tattoos and they be in the sex videos and thinking that people can't match them, huh?
Hello, didn't you see what I just said? I have a tattoo.
I can't even do that on camera no more because I got scars of
you. You shouldn't have been doing it.
Don't worry about it. Does everybody do this? Now, I've seen some stuff.
You ain't seen no stuff on me. If you saw stuff on me, it's because I showed you.
That's what I'm talking about.
Invisible. Not on the internet.
So you trying to.
Not on the internet.
let you know now.
So that's better. Is this better enough? You getting there enough?
Well, listen, I just told you.
Okay, you know what?
Hey.
Just like.
And if you do see my face out there in the net,
don't put the face out there.
Okay, I'm doing a good job.
Right. But don't put bitch, don't put your face. Listen, they can say it's you, but they ain't got no proof.
Yeah.
If you ain't put no face on it.
What they say, first thing I'm saying is, well, that's Photoshop.
Because I can't,
that's what everybody's saying now.
But you know what's so crazy, though? Like, these young girls, like, I be seeing them, like, they be just on the camp, like, they be, and they may just be disrespectful. And your face is out there, I'm just like, oh, that's not even right. My ex girlfriend was such.
Yeah, she,
I'm just like, oh my God.
I would never do that.
I would get, and there's a lot of people doing that revenge porn stuff. So it might be cute that you suck in this thing on camera and stuff like that and with your face in it. But then when y'all break up, he got the rest of the video. So this is what you do. You make sure that you keep the video if you do that.
I told you that's how I'm going to do it.
Okay. That's right. My phone. All right. Or make sure it's on your phone. And then you lock in and I trust you.
Yeah. But just in case it's on.
Okay. Because, and then what I do is, there's a special vault on my phone that you already need a password to get to my phone. And then you need a password to get to the vault in my phone. And then, if my phone catch you trying to get in my vault and you get the code wrong, it snaps your picture so I can see who tried to get into my phone.
Oh, well, you got to get it on.
Yes! I know what I'm talking about. So, yeah. My boy is
fucked up. Baby, I can imagine what's in that book. Okay? No, I hope I probably all types of shitty butts and everything.
That's my ass! You're a liar! I wouldn't even want that kind of bitch on my phone. Because, first of all, I don't even like seeing that. Like, I like a clean looking one. Okay? Now, here we go. Oh, God, how do you discriminate? No, I said a clean. It better be clean. If it look like you got a street clean. Bitch, I don't want that in my life.
It's sitting in
the jet. And then sometimes you got people that's just, it's just, can we have a regular video? I mean, it's just nasty. It don't look right. It's got to look like Montana Fishburne.
I don't
know.
Oh, no.
I don't want that in my phone.
Do you?
Do you remember that shit?
Yes. I just, and Ryan Puffer did her so wrong.
Yeah, he's looking so wrong these days.
No, he's not. No, he's not.
He didn't even get no videos.
No, he's not. Out there. He's doing his own thing.
So I heard he was out there.
No, he's not doing that.
No,
I think he's about Mr. Martin.
I heard he get you. Oh, I heard he did.
Yeah.
Let me tell you something. Oh, he's old school.
He's old school, old school. And I didn't know Ryan Puffer was that young.
He's a kid starting out.
Yeah, but he looks old. And I think it's because of all those muscles.
Yeah,
but he looks like 31 things like, too.
He looks like Lloyd Banks to me. Well,
yeah. But better version of Lloyd Banks. A much better version. Much better.
Lloyd Banks had both of them look blank anyway, so.
Well, listen, don't do that.
I mean, you can. Right. Come on, I just look at Lloyd Banks and tell you what.
Lloyd Banks don't look right.
Right,
yeah, he does.
He just looks like because he's a nice looking man.
He looks right.
No, he doesn't look right, but he's nice looking.
Yeah,
and what is this girl on your phone?
This is cool,
stupid. I'm like, you got your own section for him?
No!
Now pull up Lloyd Banks.
No, he's only 36.
Yeah.
He's been out for a long time, though.
They're like, don't you get it? But you know what? Sometimes I want to mind my business, but it's hard, but I don't. Cause some people be like posting stuff, and I just be like, you don't want to do that, don't put your body out there like that. Just, he look bad now, but
I don't know which one is him now.
They all the same. Yeah, you right about that.
Yeah, I am right about that.
Yeah, because I don't even know what
this is. I guess that's the case.
And he looks much cleaner.
Yeah, he's clean and he always looks
yeah.
Now he needs to stop wearing all these big bag clothes like it's 2001 because it's not 2001. Right,
so what we yeah, so, you know, if I see somebody being a dot on Instagram, you know, I write them on their page like, you want to do that. Don't get into that because there is no life after porn. Like, I mean, you could have life after porn, but it's like, there's no really no benefits to being in porn. And what if you want a real, a nice little job?
Let's say you somebody finds you. God, he says, yes, he should make a change.
Yeah, I would do that. Yeah, but you know what? I went to school
there.
I had it, but man, I couldn't believe Now some people can get the benefits of it, like getting a show. Okay, but then all the only people want to do is have sex with you. And if you want to do it, you might be doing it for money. Like, you don't want to do that. But some people do it. And I say, we're proud to them. But think about...
Are y'all listening to this one?
Who? No. He was one of the girls back in the day. Like, we already knew. But he wasn't out there like that. But when I see them on camera, I'm just like, oh, my God. That's such and such Robinson. I remember.
Don't put nobody's name.
And I told her a couple weeks ago that Ghost and Caleb was going to get back together and start working together. I didn't know how, I didn't know why, but because it just had a creepy, like,
but now, what's your name? Now everybody's on Dre. Dre's on everybody's shit. Yeah.
And Dre's going to survive for a long time. And when he died, you remember he kept him up the painful, slow, painful death? That's what's going to happen to
I want it to be a
Dre.
Huh? I want it to be a painful slow death. Yeah. I want each and every one of them to take turns.
They're going to fuck him up. First of all, I hated that Tootsie thing with the nails. Like, damn, man, I can't look at shit that
I can't do with Drake.
I can't.
I can look at stuff like that. I can't look at stuff when people are snorting their chain on the
wall. That bothers me.
That bothers me.
I mean, I can don't snort the eyes. Listen, bitch, I wish I better not have. I don't care. Anything that goes, I ain't going to never try to do that. I've seen the effects of what it do to people, and I don't want that to do.
Yeah.
Bitch, I've seen people on ecstasy, I've seen people on this and that, and I've never like, ooh, that ain't for me.
Not for me. Make that fatty way.
Never thought of a phone.
No, you won't.
Bitch, you be dead. Yeah. And then these
new drugs.
You think, you know they only doing these commercials because too many of them are dying. Because,
okay,
when our people stop dying,
they
oh, you ain't do all of this? Oh, you want to lock us up for 20, 50 years, now you want to help these people. You know, but you know, it is serious, because too many people are dying from the opioid, drug opioid epidemic. But yeah, back to power. So Raina is gone. I was over Angela thinking that she can ask the, what's her name? The mom. What's her name? Her name blinked my mind. I kind of think of Tori. Tasha. Did your son kill his sister? Why would you have the balls to even ask her that? You know that didn't go well. But it was just seeing like they needed each other. Like now, at one point, Angela needed Tasha, mm-hmm. and you know, she gave her ass and all that. But now, Tasha needs Angela. Mm-hmm. And you know, we seen that from that perspective. We seen that Dre is going to go down somewhere. He killed that old man. But the old man was running about too much. You don't say what's going on. You don't give nobody no chance to kill you. None of this shit. You just you know, you gotta get him when you win, by the people.
Right.
So that old man fucked up, the father fucked up, so he's cool. The son, like, I loved how it all played out with everybody going to the same place at the same damn time. Like, it was just so decent to see that with Tommy finding his own way to get there, with Ghost finding his own way, with Tasha finding her way, and with the son finding his way to this apartment to kill the man. And then now, the same people, the same reasons why he hated his mother and his father, but more so his father for being the killer that he thought that he was and everything. Now, as much as he don't want to be in the game, he is a part of the game. And it all started with Tasha Tucker and Powell to get away from murder. So that was just a, like, it was just great, right? I want to say beautiful. I shouldn't say beautiful, but the way all of this came together, it was a beautiful plan in this story. And there's more to it, because Ghost and Tasha, they still got their own issues, and now, don't think that they're not going to be on their ass in season 5 about who killed this cop, and Angela already has an idea of what's going on, so who knows what Angela's going to do, and she might try to take Tasha going to take the fall, everything. It's just like, no! I'm nervous, I'm scared, but seeing Tommy, Kanan, and Ghost all together in the car, and then the tracker was at the back of the car, it's just like, oh my God, it's going to go down in season 5. And who knows, Kanan and Ghost might get into some issues because they still haven't resolved things after 10 years. It's a lot of ways that they're going to spend this and play this, but season 5 is going to be the best season of Power. I really believe it's going to be the best season. And then you got the crooked cop telling the crooked cop and the councilman telling the Ghost how they're going to run the field and how things are going to be done from here and how he can't be that street person no more. They're all doing it for their own political game.
Which crooked cop talk about the funeral?
Not the crooked cop, the crooked priest.
Yes, I couldn't believe that.
Yeah. The crooked priest. I can't even say priest.
Priest.
Whatever.
He made the call.
How you going to tell me how I'm going to do my daughter's too? And you're going to do it here.
And you're going to do it here, and you're going to do it this way.
Yeah.
And this is all, and I'm going to stand next to you when you get up there and speak.
I'm like, huh?
Yeah. But you know, you got some people like that. Because it brings, you know, they want all this publicity for them, and you know, it brings notoriety and all this sort of bullshit. And it's just a mess.
I'm going to be mad at home church.
That's what we're going to do.
Yeah. It's be like that. Some churches don't even want you if you weren't even a member there, or if they don't know you to have a church, they don't want you in there.
Is that, I haven't come across a church like that, but then when I heard about that church, that guy who got killed a few months ago, and they didn't want his funeral, told the family he couldn't have his funeral there because of the way he was killed. And I was just like, huh? But then I thought about it, but that cop that was killed, and they had that funeral there, so I guess it all depends on who you are, which I didn't like that. And that ain't got nothing to do with the church. It has everything to do with that man or man himself who's in the church, running the church. Because I would have never did or said anything like that.
Some churches are like that. But they charge you more. They got to do what they want. They do it.
I just feel like that's something that I would have never, I wouldn't have been, as a Christian, I wouldn't have been able to look somebody in the face and say, well, because of how your child was killed, though, they can't have that funeral. Huh?
Because
and I don't know they were lying when they told me that. Then I called myself, and they said yes.
But it's a shame the way that person got killed.
Yeah, it was. But my thing was, you know, okay, so, but the cop got killed the same exact way. And go ahead and come up with the police officer. Yeah, strong police officer, right. But I guess the police officer's life was more valuable than this young guy's life. It just was bad. That particular church right there, and I can't say that I will never go in that church because, like, again, the church itself has nothing to do with it's that man or whoever it is that who
I've never
sit. I've been in there like
22 years. I remember
a long time. And you know what's so funny? I don't know longer than that. 1992.
Oh, 92?
Yup. And I thought it was like the early 2000s, but it was 1992 because that church bought that property after they tore down the stadium, because that's where that stadium used to be at. And I never kind of met. And I never knew that church was there for that long. I'm thinking like, dang, I thought maybe the church came about in the early 2000s. Because it looks like a new, you know, but it's just the, on the brick.
It was ahead of its time. Mm-hmm. That connected. I remember it. That helped McDonald's get a lot of money because you got the Catholic Church on 23rd Street. And they are.
And church people love McDonald's.
Oh, yeah, right at the bench, right at, or before or after.
Let me tell you something. When our building used to be at 40th and Samson, that McDonald's that's still there was still there then. It's been there for over 30 years because I was a child with Miss Bill going to that McDonald's in the morning for church.
Yes.
A child.
I used to love you something and cheese biscuits.
And that McDonald's is still there. And I said to Nikki, who goes to my church, I said, Nikki, isn't it funny? I say ever since like everywhere St. Joseph goes is always in McDonald's because our new location is McDonald's right on the street. But that one down the street is packed for Sunday mornings. You don't even want to go there. You got to go packed. Two packed.
I
love McDonald's breakfast.
I had Chick-fil-A the other day. That's like one of the best restaurants you can get a good meal from.
Yeah, when especially when you're satisfied when you get up.
Yeah, and when you're hungry.
Oh, the fries is too hard to chill thinking about it. The fries is that those sandwiches send me straight to the bathroom.
Oh, I got chills thinking about Chick-fil-A.
It sends me straight to the bathroom.
Yeah, that's right. It's nice to get the milkshake instead of the drink.
You know, the milkshake don't have to do it. It's chicken. Damn, it is, I don't know if they make the chicken with, but it's just straight to the
best. Right, and it got spicy chicken. And it's nasty, so I'm not going to say it.
Don't say it, because I don't want to.
But yeah, that's on fire. It's on fire. It's like real fire.
Yeah. It doesn't make the touch on fire. That's it. It's good. It's worth it. It's worth that pain.
There's no pain. It's just basically.
Well, you used to be on fire, so it's kind of trying to be one more time.
So a lot of things I can't do anymore. Those are my
things. I can't play those games with you. You have to stress them.
Oh my God! Always go into him at
Mm. Come on, I don't you ever don't you grab the thing and something
and
start coming out.
Yeah,
what you say you get what?
Equifax is a massive data breach. Credit report firms and security reason they compromised.
What's the next topic?
So it's
all video.
Yeah.
DACA.
DACA. Listen. This is what I've come to the realization that when it comes to DACA. DACA gotta go. And people might be mad for me saying this, but I'm gonna say it. It has to go. And it has to go because these people been in this country since they've been children. And their parents went to hand and didn't ask to come here. We need to get rid of DACA and find a way to give these people a pathway to citizenship. And there should be no reason why they gotta keep paying the country all of this money to be here, and they can't even vote, and they still gotta pay taxes. If they're paying taxes, then they need to be citizens of this state, of this country. So I don't think they're going to deport anybody. Especially when I look at the rules for DACA, they say you can't have no criminals, you can't have no record, or none of that stuff. Most of these people have none of them have no records, and 91% of them are employed. Some go to college and stuff like that. So if these people are on the right track, then Donald Trump, these are not the people who you oppose, mm-hmm. who you want to be here. What you need to do is find a way to make all of them become American citizens. Because it's time. All of these old people, they got to pay like $500 a year or like $500 every 2 years to be here and not get sent back to their home country. America is most of them are all the thing though. What they need to do is give them a pathway to citizenship. That's why I think it has to go. And it should not be hard for Republicans and Democrats to get together. But see, it's always a political game, and you're playing a political game with people's lives. Like, people been here all of this time. Come on. It's time to do something and let them become legal here. Especially if they're paying taxes. You take a tax off their fucking check, then they need to be a citizen. They can't even vote. I don't believe they can vote. They can't even vote. But they can be here and pay.
I just don't want anybody who was born to this country
by their parents, you know, illegally, and they, you know, they did nothing wrong. They're working. I don't want those people to be sent away simply because, you know, the decisions that their parents made. Because there's many of their parents did what they did, you know, to try to better themselves. Yes, they may have done it the wrong way, but they did it to try to better themselves. And see, with me, I'm always on the fence because it's kind of like, yeah, you know, people definitely should not come to this country illegally. No, because we can't go over there where they live at illegally. So they shouldn't come over here illegally. They should all come over here the right way. But it's unfortunate, it's sad when you have people coming over here, and you know why they're coming over here, to get away from what it is that they're living in.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And it breaks your heart because you're saying to yourself, you know, you want them to come legally, but you're like, I don't want them to continue to stay in whatever it is situation that they're staying in. And it's so unfortunate, but it's like, you know, it has to be done the right way.
Yeah, and I think it's time to let them become American citizens. And that's for a lot of people. If they're already here and they're undocumented, it's just time to just let them become citizens and, like, do an extensive background check on those who did not sign up for DACA. But I'm not saying that DACA is a bad thing,
mm-hmm.
but I just think that it should end to give these people a pathway to citizenship. Like, and then all of these people signed up with to the government thinking that they won't be deported. I don't think they're going to be deported anyway. But the people in Congress need to come up with a better solution for these people.
I also think, too, that, you know, you have a lot of illegal immigrants that come over to this country, and they're looking for work. Yes, they are. But I feel like that whole notion of they're stealing jobs away from us,
that's bullshit.
That's not true.
Even work
because I don't know anybody, us Americans, who are looking to work in anybody's field. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Or to do the labor that a lot of them do. And I'm not trying to discredit them, because any job that you have is a blessing to have. Whether you're working in somebody's field, cleaning somebody's house, mowing somebody's lawn, that is a blessing because you are employed and you're getting income coming in. You're not robbing nobody. You're not stealing from nobody. You're doing it in the honest way. So that is a blessing. But I don't know too many of us who are searching for a job to be in a field picking oranges or things like that. And, you know, yes, a lot of them are coming over because that's what a lot of them do in their country. So they're trying to find better lives here in America. And if they can get paid more doing what they did over there, then they'll come over here and do it. But I don't believe that whole notion that all these Mexicans are coming over here and they're stealing our jobs. Now, I don't believe that at all, because I don't see them. I don't see too many of them at my job. You see what I'm saying? Like, I don't see that.
There's nobody stealing those jobs.
No. And if they're coming over here illegally, how are they even able to steal our job when they don't have no proper documentation to get a job?
That's right.
So how are they stealing our job?
They're not.
They would have to have some type of proper documentation to get a job where we work at. No, they're taking the jobs that don't require proper documentation. All it requires is you want to work, all right, come in tomorrow morning.
Yeah, because I can name a lot of people that don't even want a job, but I'm not even going to say no names.
So, well, okay.
I could just work on my way out to work outside my window. They ain't complaining about nobody getting taken.
I don't work for the white man.
Yeah. This is the stupidest shit I've ever heard.
I don't want to work for the white man, but you also don't want to work for some of the black man either. Because some of them was just right.
It's not to work with them.
Okay? So you better pick and choose who you want to work for, because some of the niggas out there, they'll do you just as wrong as some of the white folks.
Yeah.
Okay? And don't let some black people get in position, because they'll really turn their nose up at you. You're like, damn, brother, we come from the same. Oh, well, so you better choose your words carefully when you say you don't want to work for the white man.
Because
there's some white folks that do you better than some of these niggas out there.
They pay you better.
And pay you better.
Oh, this is making me think about that conversation. Like, I hate hearing I don't want to work for. Well, I just hate that.
I hate that too. No, don't say you don't want to work for the white man. Say your lazy ass just don't want to work.
Mm-hmm.
Period. So we can eliminate all this. I don't work for the white man. The white man. I don't work for the white man. You don't even know the white man.
Yeah. And Colin Kaepernick, if they wanted to get that man a job, they would have given him a job. A lot of these homeless are in with Trump. And you know Trump already done tweeted about it, and they don't want to fall out with Trump, because you don't know what kind of deals they got going on with Trump. But this is all based, I believe, is all on the president. I don't think that has nothing to do with them bringing that open attention to a team, because most of these football teams, they need attention anyway. And a lot of stuff that people go on, like these football players, they be raping these girls, molesting these girls, or doing all kinds of stuff, beating their wives up, and beating dogs up, and beating all these other animals up, and they can still come back and end up get a job. Don't tell me it's about them standing up and stuff. It goes deeper than them kind of keeping and standing up for black people and the rights of others. It's way deeper than that. And I don't believe the story where Ray Lewis saying that he was about to get Kaepernick a job at the Ravens, but because his Kaepernick's girlfriend, she should not have business anyway.
Excuse.
Yeah. Because you put them as the master with the.
Because some of these girls are wives, making their husbands or boyfriends in trouble. So some of you females keep your mouth shut and let your husband or boyfriend handle what they handle at their job. Yeah. And some of y'all don't like to keep your mouth shut and y'all get them fired or in trouble.
But then we had another football player, and he had his thing going on with the cops, and we seen a video, a lot of people didn't believe in that. When they seen the video, a lot of people had something to say. I can't remember his name, but it's just like, come on, it's a real thing going on, and these football players might use their platform to get the word out. They should be able to use their platform. That's all it is to it. They should be able to use their platform and their influence. And the NFL, y'all should be stepping up too, to say that this is wrong. Because you recognize other things, you recognize other cancers and diseases and stuff like that. Why can't y'all step up and say something about the racial equality going on in the country? Why not? What's wrong with racial equality? We all should treat every race the same way. Whether you're black, white, Indian, Puerto Rican, or excuse me, Latino, or whatever. No matter where you come from.
It's 2017. Like, it's she and me, but like I always say, there's going to be, as long as the sun is shining, it's going to always be racist.
Yeah.
But it's just like, in 2017, after we have dealt with the black president for 8 years, it's like, come on, are y'all for real?
Like, it got worse. Then now these people are like, oh, they really couldn't stand a white man being in there. I mean, a black man being in there. And you know, this country's so crazy. And another great thing that's happening this weekend, or happening tonight, actually. You got three black women in the semifinals of the U.S. Open. The first time this has ever happened. So Venus Williams, Sloane Stephens, and Madison Keys, and another American woman, Coco Vanderwood, they are all competing for the U.S. Open. And I believe this is the first time this has happened in like 35 years, where you got four American women. So there's just a lot of stuff going on in our country. Great things going on. And then it's just like, I don't know, you guys. It's just, I feel bad for Kaepernick, but he's going to be all right. But I want to know what he's going to do with that money run out, because he's just donating here and there and everywhere. Like,
well, I'm sure he'll be able to get a, what do you call those things? Those,
I don't know,
announcers thing, because I'm sure somebody hired
him. Oh, maybe that would, I feel like, yeah. Well, he's going to bring unwanted attention here, too.
No, well, I mean, but I think he'll get it. He'll get some type of income. Yeah. And hopefully he'll get it soon.
Yeah. Because it's not that he needs a job. He should be on a football team. Because there's a lot of teams with mediocre players on there. And a lot of teams with injured quarterbacks, too. Why can't he play? So that's just how we all feel about it. It's all a bunch of bullshit. And he should be on the team. But I want to say thank y'all for watching. And it's a long video.
It's a very long video. Because I've been going for it. I've been telling myself for a very long time.
So we're going to go, you guys, be safe. I'm also going to create a playlist for those if you're being away. We'll be running away from her camera. Put a playlist together of all of her, you know, classic shows and stuff like that. If you haven't watched them, it's a lot of videos I haven't seen. That's a lot of people here. So, you know, I'm going to put that together for y'all this weekend. Make sure y'all look out for the playlist on the homepage. You guys be safe. If you have not donated to the people of Hurricane Harvey, that link is still inside our info box.
And also, too, if you are in Philadelphia or the Philadelphia area, you're close by Philly, whatever the case may be, you can also donate on my Instagram. I have a list of things that you can donate. My church, we are doing a hurricane relief package. And for the entire month of September, we are asking anyone if you have, you know, old clothes. We're asking for toiletries. We're asking for non-perishable foods. We're asking for all those things that you can bring to us, because we are going to be sending it down to one of the shelters down in Texas at the end of this month. So we don't want to just do it for 1 weekend. We want to do it for the entire month, so we are able to collect as many items as we can. So please, if you follow me on Instagram, hit me up. This Saturday, September the 9th, from 2:30 to 3:30, I will be at my church and I will be collecting items so you can bring it. Now, if you come to the church and you say, oh, well, there's a lot of people here, whatever the case may be, because I don't know, I'm sure a lot of you saw my cousin, he passed, that I was telling y'all about last week. He did, unfortunately, he passed, but he's home with the Lord, so that's not really unfortunate. He's home with the Lord. And his homegoing service is this Saturday, but, during the time that the family will be out, you know, at the gravesite, I said that that would be a perfect time for me to stay behind and collect, you know, items for folks that would like to come and donate. So that would be a good time. So you guys can hit me up on my Instagram to let me know when you guys are there. And also, Sunday, September the 10th, from 12 noon to 1:15, I will be at my church and I will be collecting items for those of you that would like to bring some on Sunday as well. So if you can't come on Saturday, come on Sunday. All the information is on my Instagram, the church location, the times, what we need, specifically what we need. We're only asking for those things that are going to and this is all to help those affected by Hurricane Harvey. And if everything all goes well, if we get a lot, then we hopefully probably will be able to split it up for those in Florida as well. But let's just hope and pray it does not get bad in Florida. So, yes.
So, thank you all for watching tonight's video. I hope you have a safe weekend. And, yeah, y'all be good. So, we'll see y'all next Monday.
Or Saturday.